by down there and update on what we're doing. We're filling out some new roads and those staff is familiar with it too. One thing we look at very hard is medical, which we've already terminated the one we had. There was 60-day notice and they were not doing the job they needed to do. They were sending people to the hospital and didn't need to go. Of course, as y'all know, when they go to the hospital, we pay for it. That's outside of contract. Right now, the budget on them was about $950,000 and then about a $600,000 contingency made in this effort. Well, our new provider is a better provider, provide more, and actually got a larger nursing staff, better doctor. It's going to be probably $70,000 to $100,000 cheaper per year. So I think the contingency is $600,000. We're going to probably, and we haven't done it in the budget right now, but probably it's going to go down to $350,000-$400,000. And this new provider, too, has a staff that collects Medicare, Medicaid, and insurance. So we're going to see some money coming back. If we haven't seen coming back, nobody's been bothered. So that's one of the big changes we made. Of course, the work program is back. It's very small right now. We're up to 20, but we probably had 5 a week. But every time you add an inmate, it's $9,000. So jail population is holding pretty steady, 620, 630. But that's one of the thorns in my side. Out of the 630 people, 500 are awaiting some kind of a court procedure. And I just made a lot of friends because I just left the bar association. I told them I was not back. Go ahead and tell us. I said, some of y'all, I said, these continuances. And one of my big things, Mr. Kruger knows, I haven't spoken to him yet, but I think I'm sure he's heard, is I'm a public defender's office. Y'all are saddled with that. And nobody get rid of it, it's sort of a bomb. But they're taking, in the old days, when I first started, the lawyer, his servitude is what I call it. For 5 years, he had to be a representative, for innocent people. Well, back in those days, you'd have a lawyer over here, and the DA over here, and the judge sitting right there, and you get a plea. And you get it done within 30 days. Well, now what you got, and I thought the defender's office was one of the main people doing it, they'll get a plea from the DA's office. Well, they got a certain amount of time to take it. They say, we're not going to take it. Then they get a hearing. They get in the hearing and they say, we want to evaluate them. So then that's another 60 days. You know it's crazy, you wouldn't be in jail. So they want to evaluate him, then they do that, and then they want another evaluation. Well, the thing that should have taken 30 days, about 6 to 8 months. And that's ridiculous. I mean, I talked to the judges about it. I'm inspired to hire a lawyer to defend some of these people to get them out of jail. We might have to do that. It might be cheaper to just say on some of the public defender. But that's Stephanie brought the numbers. And it's a conservative number right now. And I think if you were to add the buildings to this cost, and maintaining the buildings and everything else, but just the raw cost and allocating half of my staff, half of my salary, and I don't know, did you allocate the courts to it?
I did the transport.
Not the courts. See, this, you could allocate courts to the whole thing, but in that number, you're $45 a day. And it's going to continue to climb. And really, if you got allocated all the courts, and really courts ought to be totally allocated to the public, yes, you wouldn't. So every day, times 600 is $30,000 a day. And we got to find a way to get them out of jail. And the work program, we will probably get it up right now with the people we got available. And we got people calling my job. I mean, and we also have some individuals that say, hey, you got one of my best people in jail. And I pick him up, we can get single people out. We got females in the program now, too. They work in South Georgia County. But 20 of them, that's $180,000 in 6 months. So we got to push to get them out of jail. And I'm probably not going to make a lot of friends, but it's 4 years to the next election. By the way, we did bid some cars yesterday, and I appreciate y'all putting that in splice. We came in under budget. We had enough money allocated for 10, we thought. We were about 12. So. And building station's got a budget that's pretty flat for next year. We did, as y'all well know, there's a lot of administrative, and I call them non-producing, they're non-revenue position, positions I got rid of. We gone back to the road patrol, but we're getting it back to where it was roughly 10 per shift, one shift down to five, you cannot cover this county, you cannot stop the break-ins, everything else. Y'all know my wife's like, it got stolen a while back, broken into a car, so I know it all too well. So, but we're increasing that road patrol, and of course, with that, that's revenue. I brought you a January revenue sheet, you'll find it interesting. Another thing, the state patrol that did not have a good relationship with the previous administration, so they had actually pretty much quit writing tickets in Lowndes County. So the revenue between them and us this year, this month, January, the latest month I have, is $205,000. So I think you will find this significantly different. And you know, if somebody says something about writing tickets, we're writing tickets at 85 and 90 in the state. So I think that's pretty reasonable. We did get a dope deal the other night, had a load of dope. He was only doing 101. smoking the dope. We know the interdiction, we think Billy County got a load of dope. The threat of the wall, you can see the dope and the money back to 35, so I think they're training it to that program. Should have it up and running full steam, probably 90 days. We should see some growth in money.
Ashley, will you comment on the building that we talked about? We were going to build for evidence, you don't think it would? Yes, you don't think
it would. I'd like, so y'all reallocate that. I hired a very good evidence technician, the one that was there, but not even certified. So we're going with the new computers, with the new world and all that. We've got a barcode. We're purging the system, there's a lot of evidence that should have been thrown out years ago. But you got to get a court order on a lot of it. But we're going through that fast as we can. And I don't think we're going to need storage of evidence. Nothing else. I got to keep making offices we put it in. And we could find a place, but I forget what y'all had allocated. Was it 3?
3.
About
300.
How many
adjustments? You know, y'all bought the cars. I think one thing they look at too, it cost about $7,000 out for the car. So we might want to reallocate some of that if y'all want to see it. And maybe look at that. But I don't think we're going to need a building that's in the barcode. And we'll purge that more often. And there's a bunch of space I can find there.
Well, Sheriff, I will add this. Of course, number one, congratulations on the election. I had the opportunity to tell you that. We look forward to working with you at least for the next 4 years through your tenure, because I've thought often there's one citizen in Lowndes County that understands both sides of the issue when we're dealing with the Sheriff's Department, and that's you. You've been in our position, and you've been previously as the Sheriff of Lowndes County, and are now the Sheriff of Lowndes County again. So you understand what we have to deal with from the commissioner's standpoint, from the budget allocations and the restraints that's there, and you also understand law enforcement and the sheriff's department. So we look forward to working with you, and we thank you for all the efforts that you have gone through so far. Just as you hit the ground running, there's nobody else, and everybody expected you to do. You've done just that. Thank you very much.
I had a little flap at Lake Park, too. We changed the resource officer down there, but it was internal problem he had, personnel, which I can't talk about. But, got about 30 emails on how lovely he was. I just took the side, I saw him. So, if y'all hear anything about that, we got a lot of sheriff's department. I told my lady, I said, she said, I'm not voting you again. I said, we'll find somebody by the back home.
Well, it's your sheriff's department. I mean, that's clear and understood, and we understand that. We also understand our role, and the real important part is that, as I just said, from your point of view of being in our seat and being as the sheriff, you've got a unique point of view and a unique vision that nobody else in this community has ever had. And so we look forward to working with you.
I know how much you have to put up with that, Jackson. But, need, as a good steward, I need to look at revenue, you know, and I don't need speed or anything like that.
Sure.
The only revenue speed we can find on the revenue we have, but then cost, and that jail is the big, if we can get that out of cost under control, I mean, I know you've worked on it, all we all looked at, and, Marcus had me some jobs for the city, but then they backed out on it. So we're gonna get a money off.
Well, anyone, we talk about revenue, it's just like you said, anybody that's going 101 miles an hour, they need to be stopped, they need to really be carried to the jailhouse. We have discussed that, and it's issues that, is well managed, there's policies and procedures in place for that, but when you're basically up there in the super speed range, then you need to be fined, and you need to be, understand the fact is that you're a safety risk for everybody else that's out on the highway, not just yourself.
Y'all do run any about the South Georgia Con, they're one of our big forwards, and, we're actually got females looking up there, which is a first. Running Jim Warren, that much, so thank you. That, we changed that program a little bit, we used to charge them, $25, but now that we've actually bought, we're furnishing their clothes, they're wearing nice, khaki pants and pullover shirt, so they don't have the coveralls, they look a lot better, and we've cut their cost down to $25 a week to transport them and take care of them, and, because they're, you know, we're still feeding them and they're able to go the other day, but when you look at it, you save $9,000 by one of them being in it, it's a pretty worthwhile thing.
Yep.
I just wanted to add to the sheriff's remarks. I spoke with Captain Clifton earlier this week to have a total for you all whenever we discuss the animal monitoring program tomorrow. And Captain Clifton was telling me that not only you know, are they working through that process to identify people who qualify for that program, but Captain Clifton is also taking it on himself to identify people that if there seems to be some sort of inefficiency that exists that's keeping them in jail, that's something that can be worked out, then he's making those identifiers and putting people into programs without having to go through the animal monitoring program as well. So there's some things that they're doing to see.
It sounds like 12 people and it should be 50.
Right.
I mean, that's not my deal.
I agree with you, sir.
I mean, you manage 50 ankles as well as you can 12.
Yes.
As one person, but I mean, that's another cost. And we get people too, we've got a $300 fine, they're sitting there for 40 days, so it's been $2,000 to get free.
Yeah.
And I'm working with the judges on that. I mean, that's...
What we might do is move the ankle monitoring program under your purview that you manage.
I don't care.
We'll get some action, huh? Is that what you're saying? We also can use some four buildings for the jail. 76, IA, C, D.
I'd like to get down to the 2 week bar. And of course, you got to get the women separate. But for the labor, there was a question came up when I was saying about immigration and Hispanics. What's going on with that? You know, you got to prioritize, in my opinion. So, and this is what I tell ICE. I dealt with ICE back in the 90s. If they got a warrant for a bad person, a felon or something, somebody done it. Robbery or killing, but our Hispanics are not troublesome people. So do you want to go out and get a man that's working? Yeah, maybe he's not paying federal taxes, he's smarter than the rest of us. But maybe he's not paying federal taxes, but you know, he is working. He gained employment, he goes on the night and goes to bed and doesn't break in the cars and houses. Do you want to concentrate on the criminals who are doing the shooting and everything else, or go out and try and get people out of the field picking vegetables who are not, the only problem you have with the Hispanics is they don't have driver's license. And they will get drunk, and, you know, usually they're not so bad to drink and drive. So my take on ICE, you know, if they'll come show me a warrant, but we've got more important things. I'm not saying we're a sanctuary, but we got more important things to do as far as looking at this county. I mean, if you look at the calls, you know, the group we're in, calls constantly, just listen to the radio. Oh, one other subject, and I brought it to the judge. We did go to some of the new computer systems, which I'm very much in favor of. We're going to have to address the CAD system at 9/11, because not we're going to do an interface, and I'm not a computer genius, but no interface has ever worked.
judge is coming.
We're also interviewing today on going to the electronic tickets, which takes a lot of time, a lot of work, a lot of different calls. We'll be buying paper. And the body cameras are very important. And once they've all, or not, they have to be downloaded. The chip has to be taken out and downloaded. I have a clerk who does it full time. So it's by the end of the year, I'm going to find some way that we're going to go to a cloud type body camera. So we'll be driving it, automatically download it, and still do different things. So that's another thing we're going to try and do. And that'd be one less clerk position you need. You don't have to put health insurance in those cameras, right?
Sheriff, what's your take on this matter?
I'm looking at the numbers, how much we use it, and I think this past month, our usage was 37.6%, if I remember. Around 30, around a third of it. And, of course, I mean, you know, speaking honestly, they try and get us to do it on a pro rata basis. I had a problem with it. They let me do the jail on a pro rata. Because I can move those numbers just between me and Stephanie. We know how to make a budget. You can look what it was like, what it looked like if we were getting income off of it. And so the problem with if you went pro rata, well, depending on what's going to get charged with that crime, it can be hidden. So what are we paying that $250,000?
Yes, sir.
My original agreement was, it's not in writing, it's a handshake, was we put all of our equipment over there, we would pay half of the supervisors, whoever supervises the crime lab, pay half of their salary, and put our people over there to run whatever we want to run. Now, you know, it's a full city operation. And I think it needs to be looked at. I don't know what we're getting. I think last month we sent like 130 guys to the crime lab. So $20,000 a month, it's like 20,000 times 12 to 40. So
some of those items could be things very simple and quick turnaround, and some could be complex. So they're not giving you or your department, but I look at it like lending you your services and call for other services. That would be an option.
Very good convenience, you know, and sometimes, you know, quick turnaround, and, you know, if you get something, then you got somebody charged, and we're trying to get them out of jail, that could be good. But we need to look at, you know, of course, I got to go to my shift with Vernon King with the GBI, and he knows if I send something over there, I won't be calling him. So, you know, if it was work right, it could be viable, but we're not going to support 347 and use the whole thing.
My question is, the city of Lowndes has the only accredited crime, locally funded accredited crime lab in the state. Everything else, there are 12 or either state run or one's an ATF. Yep. But so the city of Lowndes, and I'm just trying to figure this out, but the city of Lowndes has a way of doing a crime lab in another city or county instead of doing it, figure out how to do it.
Well, when they say accredited, it's Scalia accredited.
Yes, sir.
When Scalia, people ask me, Scalia won't put the sheriff's department. The reason he won't put the sheriff's department is because the sheriff is a constitutional officer. And Scalia gives the control of the department to a board. You know, so accreditation is good in some ways, but, you know, it's only what the people want.
Well, I think we may, as a commission, through our discussions and negotiations with SDS, is that the crime lab is a city service. That city service is a service that the sheriff's department has the authority to decide whether he wants to use it or not use it. And so I leave that discretion up to Sheriff Paulk as far as where we go in discussions with the crime lab. But from our standpoint, whatever his decision is ultimately for us, is only going to be a budgetary decision, not on whether we play or not play. That's going to be up to Sheriff Paul.
Yeah, I don't have to have. I mean, you know, I can walk away from him today and get a book. They need to be aware of that.
That's my way as a taxpayer, kind of off the record. Even going out of line as a taxpayer, you know, community spending $1.2 million.
But I have complete confidence that Sheriff Paulk will be able to work that situation out, what's going to be best for him and his staff and his sheriff department.
And I think the city's paid $30,000 for him.
They think it's $40,000 within the last year.
Okay, well, that's going to be, I'm going to give them time out before they do the budget. No, it's going to be $45,000. We flash, bring it all to them. Y'all have nothing to do with it. But I mean, I don't think buying service will cost, you know, anybody, I mean, that none of the city's got a lot of trouble. That's a county or whoever else.
Well, I don't think the taxpayers going back to what kind of, along the line, Mr. Ornstein, I don't think the citizens, the taxpayers of this community would expect us to provide a service that is costing us more, and we're getting and we're charging less for that service than what it's costing us. They would expect us to at least recover our cost. Make a profit on it? No. Recover your cost? Yes. And I think that's what we
do. We all have information too. There's a law, state law on the books that you can actually charge them 10% of their court fine if they use you for housing. Over and above that, it comes. And so really, even negotiating point, that's a fair amount of money. You took 10% of their court fine. They have to pay, that way they're collecting money. Any other question I can answer, y'all?
I really don't. Again, thank you.
And I appreciate, you know, we need the cars. We got cars with $250,000 on.
Yes, sir.
That's what they left me to drive, so that's why I'm leasing all that. Here's the stats for January.
All right, thank you. We'll take those as you brought
that. That also shows DOT, but May 2 would be us. And the state patrol, we got a new post commander, Keenan, last week, was the one to do the great man. But they're working very closely with us now, and they're out there working with us.
Good.
Glad to have them back.
So you at the Leeds dinner tonight?
Yeah, they sure do. Yeah, Dave is still pretty good on it. She says, come out to lunch, and I'm not.